Now, friends, we're right in the midst of the first part of our gospel, which is the death of Christ. Christ died for our sins according to the Scriptures. And we find here in verse 50, Jesus, when he'd cried again with a loud voice, yielded up the ghost. They crucified him. Verse 35, and they crucified him. That's all it's told, no details at all, just these things that surrounded the crucifixion. The Spirit of God put the blanket of silence upon that cross that you and I might not look upon it to satisfy our curiosity, but he died there for your sins and mine. Now we are told in verse 51, behold, the veil of the temple was rent in twain from the top to the bottom, and the earth did quake and the rocks rent. At the death of Christ, several very notable things took place. And one was there was an earthquake. The other is that in the temple, the veil was rent, not from the bottom to the top. Man didn't do it, but from the top to the bottom. And that veil speaks of his flesh. And when his flesh was rent upon the cross, and he paid the penalty for your sin and my sin in his own body on the tree, then the way to God was opened wide so that you don't have to have a priest to go in for you. You don't have to have a preacher to go in for you. You don't have to have someone else to go in for you. You can go directly to the throne of God as a sinner through Christ. And let's emphasize that you only come to God through the Lord Jesus Christ. The only way to him is through Christ, and that was because he was rent. He died upon the cross when he gave up the ghost. Your sins and mine were paid. We come to God through him. There is one mediator between God and man, the man Christ Jesus. Now, verse 52, and the graves were open. Many bodies of the saints which slept arose, came out of the graves after his resurrection and went into the holy city and appeared unto many. Now, this is the part that we wish that more had been told us. I can't go into a great deal of detail here at all, other than to say we believe that it happened this way and these were part of that great company that went to heaven when he led captivity captive at his ascension. Now, the important thing for us to note here is that this earthquake was an intelligent earthquake. It was not just haphazard. The graves were opened by it, and many bodies of the saints which slept arose, just certain ones. I'd like to make this point here. There is a very excellent treatment of this by Bishop Nicholson in his little book entitled The Six Miracles of Calvary. Many times at Easter, or Good Friday, I should say, why, we have had the seven last words. Well, we had those for, I guess, 15 years straight. Then we decided we'd switch and take the six miracles of Calvary, use Bishop Nicholson's little book. And it was proved a rich blessing to many. I would say that if you're interested in that, go to your gospel bookstore. It's a rich little book, not only for this miracle, but there are six miracles of Calvary. You'll notice they appeared unto many. There were witnesses to it. Now when the centurion and they that were with him watching Jesus saw the earthquake and those things that were done, they feared greatly, saying, truly, this was the Son of God. And Luke said he went and stood beneath that cross. That centurion maybe didn't know a great deal, but he did know enough to take his place beneath the cross of Christ. And that's all that God ever asks any sinner to do, is just to take his place beneath the cross of Christ. He'd never read Hodge's theology or Strong's theology, and he had never read any of Augustine's City of God, and he hadn't even had any of my books, by the way. But he knew enough to take his place beneath the cross. I believe the centurion was a saved man. He witnessed these things, and these are the things that confirmed to him that this was the Son of God. and he took his place there. Verse 55, and many women were there, beholding afar off, which followed Jesus from Galilee, ministering unto him, among which was Mary Magdalene, and Mary the mother of James and Joses, and the mother of Zebedee.